We wanted to release this video today in hopes of seeking the public's help in identifying the driver who fled the scene. Again, as you look at the video, this is at the point where the driver abandons the vehicle at 285 Shooter Street. As you can see, he takes care in removing his dark, we believe like an athletic type jacket with white stripes. He begins to start wiping off the inside of the vehicle, showing that he's evidence conscious, removing any or attempting to remove any fingerprints. As he closes the door, he does the same to the exterior of the vehicle and the door handle. Again, keeping in mind the hair is in a bun, but again, if it was let loose, it'd probably be below his hair or his shoulder line. He then flees southbound through the parking or the park area towards Berkeley Street. Yep. So this is the point. This is the building's in between 285 and 295 Shooter Street. It's a blue van. He's just abandoned the vehicle. The vehicle sustained an extensive amount of damage at the front end. There was about a 1,200-foot debris field as he was getting away following the collision northbound on George Street. This is shortly after the incident. The vehicle was recovered shortly after the fatality. The fatality was originally investigated by members of traffic services. As their investigation progressed, it became clear that Mr. Doyle was targeted and the act was a deliberate intent to harm him. It's at this time that the homicide squad took over the investigation. We've learned through our investigation that a short time prior to the collision, an altercation had ensued with Mr. Doyle. I think it's just a matter of time before we have him identified. Again, it's good quality. Most of our video is good quality. And again, I would encourage the driver of this vehicle who may or may most likely will see this news conference to contact a lawyer and to do the right thing and turn himself in